Thank you, dear Ambassador Guillermo Fernández de Soto. We feel so proud that this side event was organized by you with a very good team of important people. And I would like to thank all of you for joining our ambassador and, of course, for joining this important event. So I would like to say hello to His Excellency Vincent Quelapil, President of ECOSOC, to Mr. Liu Xiumin, Undersecretary for Economic and Social Affairs. I know that Jose Antonio Campos, the President of the Committee from Development Policies, will join us also, and Mr. Robert Powell, Mario Cimoli from ECAL, and also Leslie Birman Lam, and Nabit Hanif. So I would like to thank all of you on behalf of the like-minded group of countries in support of middle-income countries. It is a pleasure to welcome all of you to this side event. Unlocking sustainable finance for middle-income countries in the context of the recovery from the COVID-19 pandemic. But let me say, I think that now we have a triple challenge. We have to recover not only from COVID-19, but also from the effects of this absurd war that Russia is having against Ukraine, because this is creating a very hard consequences for everybody in the entire world. And we are also having the consequences of this climate change. So we have a triple shock, and we have to recover, but we also have to repotentiate the capacity of our economies to create jobs, because this is what the people in the entire world need now, jobs. So the 2022 Financing for Sustainable Development Report has provided key recommendations to advance in the implementation of the Addis Ababa Action Plan agenda, emphasizing the need to recognize the multidimensional challenges and needs of developing countries in their pathway to sustainable development. Middle-income countries in particular have struggled to access to concessional and non-concessional resources that have proven to be critical to continually finance their socioeconomic recovery programs while investing in the implementation of solutions to face the planetary crisis posed by the climate change, biodiversity loss, and pollution. Being host of more than 70% of the global population, of ensuring the access to sustainable finance for middle-income countries is in the interest of all in order to achieve the sustainable development goals and have and leave no behind. Excellencies, today's event will allow us to advance our discussions on the need to take action in three critical priorities. First, strengthening the lending capacity and capital funding of multilateral development banks. These institutions have proven to be critical in the provision of countercyclical support to middle-income countries. It is therefore essential to ensure the optimization of operations and the improvement of their effectiveness and efficiency to be on time and to have enough money to provide to those to that economies. Second, the fiscal constraints and debt risks are increasing for all developing countries. Addressing debt sustainability requires a honest assessment of the achievements and challenges of the current global measures advanced by the G20 and the International Monetary Fund to introduce the appropriate solutions. Third, access to concessional finance can no longer be based on GDP criteria. It is fundamental to introduce the application of complementary measures of progress that recognize vulnerabilities to improve the effective and efficient allocation of financial flows, the realization of debt risk assessment, and to establish resilience to future shocks. As I said, now we are having three world shocks. Excellencies, For Colombia, these three priorities are closely interlinked. Finally, I would like to emphasize that financing and budgeting in the context of the recovery from COVID-19 pandemic also needs to consider a gender-responsive approach. That is why, at the national level, Colombia has been working alongside United Nations Women to issue sovereign gender bonds that aim to finance entrepreneurial initiatives led by women. Let me say, for the entire history of humanity, 50% of the population have been apart from political power and economic power. Now we need to include women every single day in the economy. And we also need to include women in economic power to lead companies, to create new business, but not only small micro businesses, we need women creating medium-sized, large-sized companies in order to create jobs, in order to create wealth. So we have to include this 50% in the population in the creation of wealth, in the leadership and power in the economy, and of course, with more leadership and power in the political side. We expect this event will allow us to develop a common view on the importance of the three measures, not only as part of the Financing for Development Forum outcome document, but on the need to strengthening them in preparation of the negotiations to come during the 77th session of the General Assembly. I thank you, and thank again Ambassador Guillermo Fernández de Soto for this initiative. Thank you.